What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Game Over Gerkinman. I almost said welcome back to TTG players just then. Oh man, like the old days. But yes, welcome back to Demon Souls. Now, today, I had to think about this. I had a long think about what we achieved last time. So last time we killed the Tower Knight. And a bit of an explanation of what people normally do after they do that. A lot of people will then come to this place, which is the Shrine of Storms. There's a particular character you can get here, you can kill here, and they will give you a weapon. It's a kind of scimitar, but it's got a +3 rating, which is, you know, a pretty good start early in the game. Personally, even though it's quite powerful, I'm not a really big fan of it. I just don't like the way the scimitars handle. That's really all it comes down to. Now, last time I played through it, the next place I went was here. The Archstone of the Tower Queen, which is a pretty cool area, but I want to not do things entirely conventionally. My goal for the next two episodes is we're going to be going to here, Stonefang Tunnel, but we're not going to be fighting the boss here. I kind of suck against the boss in this area. No, my plan is we're going to come in here and we're going to basically just get a bunch of ore, and we're going to be using that to upgrade our bastard sword. Basically, by upgrading our bastard sword, that'll make a lot of parts of the game much easier. So the next tour, I could go that way, by the way. You can see there's a crystal lizard there. I'm not going to, because there's no way to actually catch that crystal lizard from here. It'll start running away too soon. So once I get soul arrow, that's when I'll go after him. But until then, I'm just going to leave him on his own to do his work. But so I'm going to spend the next two episodes in this area, but we're not going to play through the whole of it. So I'm going to make a single run through there, get as many souls as I can, and as many ores as I can. And then when we get back, we're going to come to this guy here. And he actually sells Crescent Moon Grass, which is obviously quite nice. But he also sells Hardstone and Sharpstone, and we're going to be buying a whole bunch of that so we can get this bastard sword up to speed. And that's our goal for the next two episodes. So in this one, I'm going to play up to the first... play through the first little section, and then after that we're going to... Whoops, that was a little gung-ho of me. We're going to play through to the... basically where the shortcut is to the boss. Now these guys are really... I'm getting a little careless this morning. So how are we all doing today? We're doing good. I really hope you all are. I've just had a big coffee. Was up late last night. Well, I wouldn't say up late last night. I was doing some work on Flatwoods last night, some animation work. That was all going pretty well, and then I played some of the AM2R, another Metroid 2 remake. So I played the first probably half an hour of that. The Tatl Tael Gaming channel, some of you may have noticed I recently... maybe it hasn't started by the time this... no, it should have started by the time this has come out. Did a playthrough of Metroid 2 for the original Game Boy. And so it was funny, so like soon after that, going to play this remake, which is, I'm not gonna lie, really good. This guy is a bit of a pain in the ass. I think we find this guy's easiest to just jump in, give him a good cut, jump out. I am kind of pissy with the whole Metroid 2 remake thing. Maybe it's been sorted by the time this video is out, I don't know, but as it stands at the moment, that game was in development for 4 years. I know, I thought it was for 2 years, but I got it confused with Metroid Prime 2D. Someone was doing a 2D remake of Metroid Prime with the very similar asset set to a Metroid 2 remake. But I mean, this guy's been releasing demos of the Metroid 2 remake for 4 years, and Nintendo didn't do anything. And it's only now that the game's actually finished that Nintendo's come out and basically shut it down. I just don't understand why they... because, I mean, like, the guy's been releasing demos up until this point, so it's not like Nintendo wouldn't have known that it was a thing. I mean, there's been plenty of articles written about it, there's been plenty of videos out about the demos and that sort of thing. So I don't know why they waited until the game was fully finished to tell the guy, no, actually, you can't share this. I think that's a little bullshit. I mean, they're perfectly within their rights to shut the project down. It is a fan project of one of their properties, so they own it. They can do whatever they like, and they, you know, realistically should shut it down to protect their intellectual property. But they shut it down. They should have shut it down within, you know, a month or two of finding out that the project had been started, and not waiting until the whole project was finished in order to do it. I think that's bullshit. Personally, anyway, I mean, you guys might have a different opinion, and that's fine. But, yeah, playing through that last night, and it feels so good. Oh, that frame rate dip did not feel good. It is just so, he's got the nail, the feel of Metroid, the remakes at least. It plays very much like Fusion or Zero Mission, which is most definitely a positive thing. You're very impressed, and I think I will definitely... I kind of don't want to play through any more of it, because I actually want to do a Let's Play of it on this channel. I think that'd be interesting, having my original Game Boy one on the Tatl Tael Gaming channel, which, mind you, I do sound like I'm half asleep through all of it, because that was the last thing I recorded before before I left the country, so I was feeling pretty wrecked at that point. But, yeah, this remake, like, I was smiling from ear to ear, and then the guys added in a bunch of, like, new bosses and puzzles and things like that, and so that's kind of what I want to play through it as a Let's Play first, without playing through the whole thing, because there are surprises in there, and I want to try to capture my own surprise if I can. I think that'd be pretty cool. Also, last time, you may remember, I was playing offline. I worked out why that is, and that's because Sony has updated their terms of service, and I had to do a whole bunch of stuff in the menu in order to get my PS3 back online again. And that's actually why I found the last five episodes so easy. I probably should have died at some point, but what happens was, this game has a thing called World Tendency, which I would like to be able to explain to you, but I'm not entirely sure how it works. But basically, by killing bosses, your world tendency goes up to, like, white and then pure white. And by dying, it goes down to black and pure black. And the tendency of the game world that you're currently playing in is actually sort of partly handled by the servers that you play on. And I guess by default, when you're playing offline, it must put you in a black world tendency, because you might have remembered me saying that I wasn't getting a lot of item drops. And so I looked into all this afterwards to try to work out what the hell was going on, and it turns out when you're in a black world tendency, enemies are easier to kill, like they have less health, but you get a lot less item drops. When you're in a white world tendency, enemies are much tougher, but you get a lot more item drops. Speaking of item drops, this guy just dropped a whole bunch of shards of hardstone. Very, very nice. That's some upgrade. I think that's the next upgrade almost right there for a level 2 sword. So yeah, that's what was going on there, so I'm glad I sorted that out. Also, these pots are going to explode and dogs are going to come out. None of these guys really hand out medals. You can tell which ones do have stuff on them because they have yellow eyes. No one else does. I remember dying at this bit so many times on my first playthrough. Dogs, as I said, I think in one of the previous episodes, are my least favorite enemy in the game. They're not hard to kill, but they're hard to read. Especially when they're all in a big group like that, before you get a chance to, once you've leveled up and you can kill them in one hit, it's not so bad, but their animations are, like, so erratic. Like, they don't do a ton of damage, but when you got a whole bunch, like, when you're fighting one at a time, it's like, whatever. No biggie. But when you got a whole bunch of them, they're, I find them to be quite difficult. Alright, give me that. Give me that late ring grass. That'll work. Perfect. That's not the last we'll be seeing of him either. It's one of the few times I'll ever pull out my shield is when I'm fighting those guys. But yeah, in order to get the weapon that I want, I didn't realize this until I looked it up, actually, when I was looking up these other problems, is I need to have a pure white world tendency, which means Last time I picked it up, I can only assume what happens is most of the servers must have that particular area of the game in pure white because people are trying to get that weapon constantly. Take that, you stupid fat official. You're a dead man. Shard of clear stone, very nice. Chunk of hard stone, chunk of sharp stone, very, very nice. Full moon grass. You guys are being very generous today, and I very much appreciate it. So, that weapon, hopefully, I don't know when I'll get it. It's something I'm gonna have to come back to later. This guy's a piece of shit. Look at this. His weapon bounces off walls, which is, you know, realistic, but when the game does shit like this, where it puts these enemies in these sort of positions where, you know, like literally my only option for this guy is to do an over the head swing. And I'm not nearly in a position where I can do much about it. This, I will say, if you're the sort of person who plays with spears, these sort of areas are these really narrow areas are much easier. Come here, buddy. Come on down. Come on. You can do it. Oh, two of them, and I missed. Oh, that's definitely bad. Oh, no, I'm trapped. And there we go. First death. Finally, it was bound to happen at some point. Bum bum. Alright, we're back. Let's try this again. Get my souls back, because I really don't want to lose those. Oh, Jesus. Straight into it. Alright, come here. I'm not getting stuck on the stairs this time. That was shithouse what happened last time. Oh, come on. This guy should be getting stun locked, but he's not. Because he's a jerk. Okay, that's the other thing. Yeah, so there's always this guy in here that comes out and he's like, surprise, motherfucker! This is what I get for playing without my shield. I did not see you come out. Not being particularly careful, and because I'm not wearing any armor, you can see how much damage this, like, guy's attacks do to me. So much so that I'm getting pretty low on healing items, actually, which is not ideal, but I can only blame myself. It's all my fault. Hey, Crescent Moongrass. Let's get rid of this turpentine, because I sure as shit don't need that. Here we go. And that's not what I wanted to do, but whatever. Now, the pickaxes are actually an item you can use as a weapon. I wouldn't. I think it's kind of shit. But, you know, if you want to, you can go right on ahead. Alright, so we have some options here now. If I go down there, this was actually take me back to where I just was. So we will be, I think, if I double check all of this shit. Yes, there is. Out of my way, box crates. Whereabouts am I? Yes! Okay, so, first of all, I'm going to come down here. I'm going to collect that one item that I missed. It's one we could see earlier, and it was a little bit too high and out of reach. And also down on this level here, we have these lovely guys working hard. Working hard on being dead. Yeah, these guys give out like next to no souls. They're very, very stingy. Killing them's probably, I don't really know why I'm bothering. I mean, part of the whole cool thing about the Thieves' Ring is that they, generally aren't very aggressive towards you, but for some reason I feel the need to just kill everything all the time. But I think there are some guys down here that, you can tell which ones are these, like, scaly lizard workers. These are originally humans, actually, and that's going to come into the lore in a little bit. I'll be able to show you one of the characters that's going through a transformation. But these guys with the bags of ore are the guys you want to go after, because they're the ones that'll drop what they have, which, you know, when you're trying to do what we're doing, which is, sharp stone, some large shards, good stuff. We're gonna have this, Gonna have this blade all souped up in no time. If we can get it up to like level 3 or 4, that would be awesome. But yeah, so you can see this item before when we were down here when we first came in, so I'm quickly just gonna cut to being back up there again now that we've got that. Okay, so we're back up here again. You can see this lovely fat controller here. This floor will break on us, like so. Which I guess I probably should have done before I, like, cut to me running back up there again, so I guess I'll do that again. I'm an idiot. Why did I do that? Alright, this time things are good. So, we have the, this broken thing here. We have this tiny little thin piece of, wood here we can run across. I'm going to murder this fat fuck. He's actually got quite a bit more health than most of them do. I'm not sure why that is. Well, down you go. But he's protecting a renowned hero, Soldier's Soul. Now those are something I haven't spoken about. So there's the souls that you pick up off enemies. Obviously I spend those constantly. But then there's also the other ones that you pick up off bodies. And a lot of the time those are... what people use to buy upgrades and things, they'll use their regular souls from killing things for things like leveling up and... Ow, you prick. Leveling up and that sort of thing. And then they'll use their souls that they've found on the ground to, you know, upgrade their weapons and buy items and things like that. That's generally kind of how I play in the late game. Obviously, I don't play like that the whole way through, because I just spent all my early souls on... getting my attack stat up to a high enough level to use a weapon, which I may or may not be able to get. I really hope I can get it. That would be really nice. Oh, really? You're still alive? I thought you were dead, son. Aren't you full of surprises? Fighting the good fight. Oh, shards of hardstone. Fantastic. I think I should be able to at least get this sword up to like level plus level 4. We'll see. But I'm feeling pretty confident. I am feeling quite confident. Heal just to be safe. What's up? Oh, you're dead, sons! Over the edge he goes. Well, a shard of clear stone. Clear stone's not an ore I've ever actually used. I've never used one of the weapons that'll, Thanks, computer-controlled ghost, to show me what to do. Yeah, we opened a gate. Very, very exciting. Okay, so yes, now we've done pretty much everything there is to do. Well, I mean, I've still got a few guys to kill. To get whatever ore I can. Ed's Grindstone, that thing's pretty cool. If you're ever in a position where your weapon is broken, because your weapons do degrade as you're playing through. My last playthrough, I never even got to a point where my weapon was close to breaking, but... on my first playthrough, because I was dying so frequently, it happened quite regularly. I will say that's something that makes this game extra hard on your first playthrough, is not understanding how those sorts of things work. So by dying a lot, I had to keep using my weapon a lot, and by using my weapon a lot without getting any souls, I was constantly having to, you know, it was constantly breaking. So it's definitely in... a lot more ways than one, the game gets increasingly easy the more and more you play it. It makes a huge, huge, huge difference. Alright. Normally I'd cut through this tunnel, but whatever. It's not that long, I guess. Not that big of a deal. Okay, so now that we've done all that stuff, we can come up here. Is there anything cool up here? Yes, this guy's got something for us. What do you got for us, buddy? Just some more souls, that's fine, I will happily take them. And now we can make our way through this gate, which was earlier closed. So in this episode, we're gonna play through this area as well. We're going to stop before we get to the final part of it. These guys are great. See, once I upgrade my sword, I'll be able to kill these guys in, like, pretty much... Shard of Meltstone. I'm not sure what those work on either. There's a lot of ores and things in this game that I've never actually used weapons that get, like, use a lot of this stuff, so a lot of it, even though I picked it up a million times, is stuff that I'm not really all that familiar with. Okay. I can hear a crystal lizard. I can always hear that crystal lizard here, but I've never actually found... Nope, not an invisible wall. I've never actually found where it is. Like, it sounds very close. I can hear it again now. Oh, it's up above me. That's where it probably is. There's one up on one of the, up on one of the stands. Alright, so now, there's an item over there I want to collect. I don't remember what it is, but me being me, I want to collect all the items I can. Once we get this sword upgraded, these guys will be even easier. They'll literally be one hit kills. Funny thing about these guys, when you attack them, if you're even just slightly too close to them, you'll take damage from just their heat. Which, I don't know, kind of a nice little touch, considering they're on fire. Their attack is retarded strong for what it is. They just flail at you and it hurts. Dragonstone I am familiar with, because there is a... Actually, I got this on my last playthrough that I recorded. With Paul, there is a fire sword which I used on my first playthrough. I think a lot of people actually like using it on their first playthrough because it makes life a little easier. But... Whoop. Hey guys, what's up? These guys are a little scary. These things I got will set me on fire. But yeah, use Dragonstone to upgrade fire weapons. Or, because you can get regular weapons with like elemental buffs. Not just elemental buffs, but there's like magic buffs and crushing buffs and a few other ones. So it's very useful for that side of things. Come on, you going to go down for me? Almost. Yes, thank you very much. That was the last of those dudes. So, I said we're going to play up to the shortcut, and that is exactly what we're going to do. So the shortcut is just down here. Some of you may remember this from my previous playthrough. I've got quite a lot of souls, which is good too. So what I'm going to do is be able to... I've only just worked this out on this playthrough, but the guys with the sacks of minerals, they don't seem to respawn. After you've killed them once, they seem to just get replaced by regular enemies, which I guess is supposed to make it a little harder to farm those precious minerals. Oh, right in there. Very good, sir. Large shards. I'll take them. Look at all those beautiful shards. Ah, so tasty. So good. Okay, so we have, what's this? Unknown Hero's Soul, very, very nice. And we have Crescent Moongrass. Oh, healing items are always welcome. There's something else that later on there's a particular vendor called Patches, who will show up. He shows up in the area after the stage after this one in this world, actually. And, okay. What I'm gonna do, I fucked that up. Oh, and now I've upset them. Okay, the crystal lizard didn't see me, at least that, because the crystal lizards, after you've pissed them off, they will disappear for a little while, and they won't come back until you beat bosses. So you only get a limited number of times that you can actually kill them, which is kind of a neat thing that they added. I'm going to pick up this item, which is what I meant to do, but I was so caught up talking about Patches. Yes, we get Patches in the stage after this one in this world, and he sells grass in the Nexus. So usually what I'll end up doing is I'll spend my souls on leveling up whatever I have to, and then repair my items, and usually whatever's left is spent on healing items. But this is the blacksmith for this area. So there's the blacksmith in the Nexus, and then there's this one here. And this guy does some extra little things that the one in the Nexus doesn't do. But if you look at him closely, you can see he's actually scaling over. So the guy in the Nexus is fine, and this is his brother, but he's not doing quite as well.
I haven't seen you around these parts. What does it matter? You need a blacksmith, show me some coin. If not, head straight for the door.
He's a bit of a dick, but we're going to upgrade our weapon, we're going to upgrade our bastard sword, we can... Lovely, level 2. Can we do level 3? We can. And what do we need for level 4? I need four more shards of hardstone. So, we'll be able to get up to level 4, which was, for this early in the game, makes this sword fucking OP as shit. So I'm going to buy 4 more of those from the vendor here. How you doing, buddy? I need... It was hardstone, wasn't it? Yes. Or was it sharpstone? I'll get 6, just to be safe. Thank you very much, good sir. Now, I'm going to go back down. This bit's kind of, if you're going down instead of up, he can be a bit of a pain in the ass to get to. I've actually died doing this elevator thing before, so. Okay, upgrade my weapon again, please. Bastard sword, +4. Or do I need to get a +5? Large shards of hardstone, so. Those can be bought in the next area. Like I said, this is only going to be my secondary weapon, but, why? What did I do? I didn't do anything, you jerk. But now that we've got this baby up to level +4, I feel much more confident entering some other areas of the game. So we're going to go back to the Nexus, and that's going to wrap things up for this episode. Whee! Let's go! And we're back. So... Thank you very much for joining me. Once you guys are gone, I'm just going to quickly deposit some items in with the Sockball Thomas and stuff. Not very exciting. But next time we are going to go to, I believe, the Tower of Latrine. We're going to do the first part of that area. So I hope you'll join me for that. And I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments below if you have. And you have yourself a wonderful day. I'll catch you next time. Peace out and have a good one.